With the chuckeye steaks removed, we can further merchandise the chuckeye roll. A different option is the beef chuckeye roast, also known as America's beef roast. First, we need to do some preparation. We will remove the connective tissue because this tissue is difficult to break down during dry heat cooking. We will remove the connective tissue located at the anterior or neck portion of the chuckeye. Use the knife to trim off the connective tissue by sliding your knife under the connective tissue. We could leave the roast whole for larger portioning or trim it and portion it into smaller roasts. We will cut it in half. Now we have America's beef roast. For a leaner option, we open the remaining part of the chuckeye and remove the internal fat. We start at the anterior or neck end of the chuckeye. We will start at the neck end and follow the heavy seam of fat. You can follow the seam, but you need to be careful not to score the meat. You want to make your cuts so you can open it up, like you open a book. Continue to follow the seam and do not completely separate this muscle, because we want to leave it attached. We can now remove the excess internal fat exposed. We use our knife to gently remove the excess fat. Remove as little or as much fat as you like. Now we will close the book after removal of the fat. You can either tie or stuff it. We will demonstrate the stuffing method using a horn with netting. We can take the chuckeye and place the netting around it. Remove any excess netting material. You can leave it whole or cut it into smaller portions. Dry roast in the oven at medium rare to medium doneness for the perfect meal. It's versatile enough for serving at a special occasion or as part of the daily routine. Slice for a delicious and succulent beef sandwich.